for prayer. They ask Mary or they ask other saints. The Bible says you shall call no man on earth father and have no false idols. And that's exactly what the Catholics do. And we see it in other religions. Just like as Hinduism and Buddhism, they have all these statues and all these gods that don't do anything. They're praying to just pieces of rock, pieces of clay that don't mean anything. If you look at any religious leader, Buddha, Muhammad, and they asked them, in the scripture they asked them and they said they didn't know the way to heaven. They weren't for sure. They couldn't guarantee you salvation. Not Muhammad, not Buddha, not nobody. Jesus Christ was the only one that said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody comes to the Father except by me. He's the only one in any religion that claims to know how to go to heaven. There's not one, not in Islam. If you ask a Muslim, are you going to heaven? They're going to say, well, I think so. I think I am. I mean, I'm a good person. I don't kill people, so I think I'll go to heaven. If you ask a Catholic, are you going to heaven? They're going to say, well, you know, I pray the rosary and I like candles and, you know, I go to mass once a year and I believe God loves me, so I'm saved. So what they're doing is they're trying to get them away with as much as possible. And that's not the attitude we're supposed to have. They do all these little things, these routines in order to be saved. Just going to church in this routine over and over and over again. That doesn't save us. Only trusting in the true God, repenting of our sin and trusting the true God. There's a reason why the Bible can guarantee